up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are here with some Detroit Lions news. The Lions are waiving a player on an injury settlement. It's kind of like a small end of an era today for the Detroit Lions. We're talking about a guy that's been here now for 4 seasons, but unfortunately he hasn't seen the field very much due to a crazy amount of injuries. And today, he has been waived on an injury settlement. So let's get this started.
The city's been down, and it found a way to get up. And when you knock us down, we're going to get up. And on the way up, we're going to bite a kneecap off, all right? And we're going to stand up, and then it's going to take 2 more shots to knock us down. We're going to take another hunk out of you. Before long, we're going to be the last one standing.
Welcome, everybody, to another video. Glad you guys are here, and we're here to talk some Detroit Lions news. So I'm sure you read the title. And that's, you know, you clicked on the video, so you know who we're talking about. If you didn't even read the title and you clicked on this video, shout out to you. That's crazy. I don't know how you did that. If you did that, shout out to you. But we're talking about a guy that we all know. It's Deshaun Hand. He's in his 4th season with the Lions. He's set to become a free agent after this season. And today, he has been waived on an injury settlement, so he'll have an opportunity to play elsewhere. And it feels like a small little end of an era sort of here, because this is a guy that, I mean, we've said it for years now. Guys, he's been placed on IR 5 times. And here for 4 seasons, he's been placed on IR 5 times. He's missed more games than he's played, all right? So that just kind of sums up the amount of injuries this guy has dealt with the Lions. And we've seen him. We saw him back in 2018. We saw him in his rookie season flash. We saw him against Green Bay. He, you know, PFF loved the guy. And it was like, oh, snap, we might have something here. And then injuries on top of injuries on top of injuries. And it's kept reoccurring. And now this season, he's been placed on IR twice. And because he's been placed on IR twice, he can't come back to play this season. So he is going to be waived on an injury settlement, which according to reports, he should be out for a few weeks, but he could return this season. So if there's like a playoff team out there that's like, hey, we could use some D-line help, they could pick him up, bring him in for the playoffs. I'm wishing him the best. I'm hoping this is an opportunity, just a fresh start, and maybe somehow that keeps him healthy and he can find some success in the NFL. But man, it just did not happen with the Lions because of all the crazy amount of injuries that he has dealt with. Look back to 2018. You go back to his rookie season. He missed 3 games that year. He sprained his MCL in his right knee. Now, 2018 was his best statistical season. The guy had 3 sacks, 9 pressures, 27 total tackles. I know PFF loved him, you know, as a rookie interior defensive lineman. He made that great play on Aaron Rodgers. He looked relentless. I mean, you got to remember, coming out of high school, this guy was the #1 ranked number one, I'm talking above Myles Garrett. I'm talking about Deshaun Watson. Like, he was up there coming out of high school. Now, in college, he never really lived up to that with Alabama. Obviously, it's a great school, great competition. He didn't really live up to that, but he was still drafted by the Lions in the 4th round. Athletic defensive lineman that we knew had a lot of upside, but then the injuries just hit. And it started in 2018. It wasn't like he missed a ton of games, but he missed a few. And then it just kind of carried over from there. 2019, you're excited to see his 2nd season, but he barely even plays. He only plays in 3 games in 2019. Elbow injury, ankle injury. He missed his 1st 6 games, came back for 2, then he got his ankle injured and re-injured it again, and he was out, placed on IR. 2020, you look at 2020, groin injury. It ended the entire season. He only played in 10 games in 2020, which was sort of back to it a little bit. And so far this season, he's technically only played in 3 games. He only has stat logs from 2 games because that's how much he's played. Like, he played against Cleveland for like a couple of snaps. I can't remember the exact amount, like 12% or something like that. And he re-injured his groin. So then he got placed back on IR. And remember, there was an initial setback that happened this offseason because he was super excited. And I was so excited for him because, again, this is a guy that the Lions looked at. They're like, man, he can play. Our job is to keep him healthy. That's what we're going to try to do, is keep him healthy. So I was excited. The way that he talked to the media, he was so excited. He's like, you know, I got in shape. I bulked up. I put on about 20 pounds. He went from about 270, which is where he was playing at 2020, to about 293 range, which is pretty much identical to Levi. So he kind of had a similar body type in terms of what he put on. So he put on a little more weight to fit this defense. Every next day, he gets injured. How unlucky is that? The very next day he's hurt, and the Lions came out and like, man, it's going to be a little longer than we thought it was. But they wanted to get him back. And granted to the Lions, it's not like they didn't go out and give him a chance. It's not like when he was healthy, Lions said, nah, we ain't putting you on the field. When he was healthy, when he came back, let's say against Pittsburgh, the guy played his career high in snaps defensively. 78% of the snaps he found the field against Pittsburgh. So they gave him a chance. Now, they only had 2 tackles in that game, but they gave him an opportunity. And he's set to become a free agent where you would have to pay him. And when you look at the history of injuries, it's hard to say that, yeah, we'll keep him around. And, you know, we're going to bring him back this offseason. I'm going to do that with a guy guy that hasn't played much. It's tough to look at, you know, his past and see what he's done. And now for this season, barely getting to see him. Adjust to defensive schemes. This is what happens a lot with us because we change regimes a ton. Now this one, they tried to do a good job of just saying, okay, we're going to put you in the best spot to be successful. We're going to try to put you where we can make it work. So they gave guy chances. They gave him an opportunity. It's just unfortunate that, again, he went down with an injury. He released a guy on an injury settlement. They're basically going to project the amount of time he's going to miss. They're going to pay him for that time. And it's supposed to save the Lions roughly $300,000 in cash space. So it can save us a little bit. You know, nothing really crazy here because he's going to be a free agent anyway. But save us a little bit of cash space. It won't open up a roster spot because he was already on IR. So we already had him there. So it's not like, oh, we get a new spot because he's gone now. Like, we already had that spot because he was already placed on IR. Of course, we didn't see him last week because he was placed on IR. And the Lions defensively, they did some things differently. They played a lot more pass rushers, edge rushers, because we didn't have Trey Flowers. We didn't have Deshaun Andy. You don't have Romeo Okoro, of course. So the Lions adjusted. They played a little more outside linebackers on the field, trying to get some pressure. Didn't necessarily work as well as they would have liked it to. We'll talk about that in a second. He built his body very similar to Levi. He's one of those guys that even coming out of the draft, you looked at him as, okay, if he's in a 3-4, you can play DN. If he's in a 4-3, you play him maybe even as a defensive tackle for us. He played a lot of that, you know, 5-tech kind of role, and then he would kind of slide inside. And that's really where he's seemingly been most impactful is when he slides inside. He doesn't really get a ton of pass rush when he's playing against an offensive tackle on early downs. He doesn't seem to get a lot there. You know, he doesn't have any speed moves, you know, nothing like that. It's a lot of just power moves, bull rush. But when he gets in the inside, he's has enough athleticism to kind of, you know, get an advantage against centers, against guards, really 0-3 tech. That's where he's found some success. And we saw it against the Packers going back to his rookie season. Even now, that's how the Lions used him. I think he may have lost a little bit of explosiveness, knowing that he balked up a little bit trying to fit this defense. I think that's very possible, but it's hard to say that because we didn't see like a huge sample size to really say for sure that that's what happened. Really saw a lot less of a Lee McNeil. They came in, they let Deshaun Hand get a lot of snaps. We saw a lot less of a Lee McNeil into that game. And then this past week with no Deshaun Hand, with no Trey Flowers, like I said, the Lions went to more of these outside linebackers. They went more Julian, Austin Bryant, Charles Harris as a whole. You know, Jesse had his, you know, season debut. He had his NFL debut, I think, in a regular season game. We saw him a few snaps in that game as well. Lions lean more that way. So as a whole, it was just way less defensive linemen. It was less Levi. It was less Aleem. Even though they did flash a few times, Levi had his first sack. Aleem McNeil made some plays. And I do anticipate seeing more of those guys going forward now without having a Deshaun Hand and where we're at in the season. I think we'll see more of the young guys, specifically in this last game. Like, the Lions right now are struggling to get pressure. And one thing with Trey Flowers is that Trey Flowers was able to give us a little bit of pressure, you know, playing that outside linebacker defensive end position. That's not to say that he's worth the money that he's been getting paid, but at the same time, he was able to get us some pressure in some one-on-one situations. If you gave him those, he could get after you a little bit, but now he's missing time. So when you don't have him, you don't have Romeo, who was a big free agent bring back this offseason, was to get Romeo back, get the pass rusher, to not have either of those guys, to be where we have. Really the only guy that's been giving us pressure is Charles Harris. He has 20 pressures so far on the season, 4 sacks. He hasn't had a couple recently. We've only had 2 sacks in the last 3 weeks defensively, okay? Let me just say that. Julian's been getting some pressure as well. We haven't seen him a ton. I think they like Austin Bryant better as an all-down run defender. Julian's given us a little bit of pressure. He has 8. He actually missed 2 sacks in his last game where he got hands on the quarterback. He just was unable to bring them down. And then the other one, he got out of his hands. And it's really, Lions have been kind of forced to bring a lot of blitzes to try to get pressure because guys aren't winning ones-on-one a ton. They do like Austin Bryant as a starter right now above Julian without Trey, without Romeo. They're playing a lot more of Austin Bryant, probably because they like Austin Bryant more as run defender. Like, one thing about this group, man, even though we're young, we can stop the run. Like, these front, you know, guys, you know, this D line that we're throwing out there, outside linebackers paired with the defensive line, with the Aleems, the Levis. Of course, Michael Brockers has been great in that group. Pennicini, we know he's not a big pass rusher, but Austin Bryant, like, guys have been and done a good job against the run. Charles even hasn't even been that bad against the run. But the emphasis on the last 2 weeks has been stop the run. I mean, the teams you've played has been, okay, stop the run with the Bears, stop the run with the Steelers, stop the Bears with the Browns, stop the run with the Browns because of the weather, because the teams that you're playing. So it's been a little bit different. And then, of course, we're just not getting the pass rush with those guys. So the last week, we went a lot of outside linebacker. We went some 3 outside linebacker sets to try to get something against the Bears. That forced us to bring some blitz and try to just draw things up to get pressure and try to get one-on-ones, because even when we're getting those, we're just not consistently winning those right now. And of course, not having Deshaun Hand, who the Lions saw as possibly an upside guy, sliding him inside on those passing downs, which is where the Lions used him a little bit. You saw a little bit of heat when they did that against Pittsburgh. Not having him, you lean more to outside linebackers. So we'll see what the Lions mix looks like for the rest of the season. I don't know what Trey Flowers' injury is looking like. We'll see where he's at and when he's able to get back. I don't think he's, you know, here long term for the Lions, but just for the rest of the season, we'll see if he's able to come back. And snap counts can vary. Like I said, I think we'll see more Levi and Ali McNeil going through the rest of the season. I think we'll see more of those two guys. They haven't given us a ton of pressure either, but they have flashed a few times recently. Specifically, I know Levi just came off a sack, which was brought in a blitz from Jalen Reeves Maven, by the way. Ali McNeil has made some plays in the backfield. I think it makes sense to give those guys some more snaps, see what they can do. And it's unfortunate this happened with Deshaun Hand. I think he could have fit in this game for sure, like playing the role they wanted him to play in this 3-4 multiple defense for the Lions that could play a little bit more on the outside. I think he had enough athleticism where we've got guys like Ali McNeil to drop, right? He has athleticism to do that. We saw him drop actually and try to chase down, I think it was Mason Rudolph. He wasn't really able to do it, but he had enough athleticism to do those little things. He wasn't the athlete to play outside linebacker, and they also didn't have him approach this offseason like that. They had him bulk up, so they weren't trying to play him an outside linebacker. They were trying to play him on the D line consistently. Like I said, probably more of a 3-4 DN, and then of course on passing downs we could slide him in. Levi was like coming out of the draft, you know, kind of how Lions were trying to, you know, play him, what it looks like going forward. But yeah, this is sort of like a little end of an era with Deshaun Hand. So obviously wishing him the best of luck. Hopefully he can find a way to stay healthy. Long term with Deshaun Hand, with the injuries he's been dealing with, probably just doesn't make sense at this point. And hopefully he can go elsewhere and find some health. Part of his game I do love is just him getting his hands up. You know, I do feel like he has that within his hand to break some passes up, get his hands up. I'm watching this back in high school. He's doing that. One thing the Lions defense wanted coming in this offseason with guys with long arms, they wanted long defenders. And he does have that part. But look at what we have Brockers, who's locked up. Levi and Aleem, of course, are going to be here. Pennicini will probably be here. I think he probably will. Another guy that's still on his rookie deal. You have those defense linemen. Nick Williams, I'm not completely sure. They do seem like to play him, but I wouldn't guarantee that he'll be back. If they do, he could be a real cheap contract, but I wouldn't guarantee that he'd be back. I don't necessarily think that he'll be back. Lions may just go a different route with that, whether it's draft or free agency. We'll see what they do this offseason. Still think they got some core pieces here. Speaking of pass rush, I do want to point out Lions pass defense has been so much better these last 3 weeks. Since the bye week, Lions have been 8th in the league in passer rating allowed. You know, 3 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, just like 230 yards a game passing. Like, they've been really good against the pass. And it's crazy that we only have 2 sacks. Weather plays into that. Some of the quarterbacks you faced, Mason Rudolph, Baker Mayfield, and Andy Dalton aren't the best quarterbacks. And 2 of the games were in terrible weather. But it's still something to be proud of, the fact that you're doing this without getting a lot of pass rush from winning one-on-ones. You're having to blitz guys to get after the quarterback. So I do credit the secondary, these linebackers. I think they've been playing pretty well, specifically Jalen Reeves-Maven and Alex Anzalone. But really looking at the secondary, a real good job in coverage. So I just wanted to point that out just to give you a good note. You know, and then, of course, later tonight, we're going to probably jump into the All-22, so stay tuned for that. But until then, thank you for watching, and I'm out.